How are you doing? Today I'm going to do something that I saw on Teen Vogue and I thought it was such a great idea. I watched Billie Eilish's one and I watched Paris Jackson's one and I just thought it was so cool, so I'm going to do my own. I'm going to do Soundtrack to My Life. I'm also going to try and keep it chronological as well so it's easier to understand. Just a little disclaimer, I'm not going to play any of the proper songs because I don't want any like copyright issues, but I will leave a link to everyone in the description below. So without further ado, let's get started. So first up we have Time in a Bottle by Jim Crochet. I absolutely love this song and I didn't start to appreciate it properly until I was about 17, 18. But my dad used to sing it to me when I was a baby to try and get me to sleep. And I never really thought about it properly until I was like in my teens and I started listening to the words and I realised it's just such a lovely song and it's so relaxing as well. Like I still have it on a like sleepy time playlist and it's still one of my favourite songs to this day. It's impossible to play, but it's lovely. I remember when I first heard it properly and first listened to the words and I was tearing up because it was so beautiful and I kept on thinking to myself, wow, Dad, you chose a really, really lovely song to sing to me. Thank you. Next up, please don't laugh at me, but the next one was Can't Get You Out of My Head by Kylie Minogue. The reason I've chosen this is because it was always on in my mum's car, and me and my mum used to just sit there and like sing and dance to it. And I remember being like so little and just loving the song so much. Like, I'm not a big Kylie fan at all now, but apparently when I was little, it was just ridiculous. Like, I'd be standing in front of the TV doing her dance moves and all that, much to the dismay of my parents. The next one is another one from my mum's car, and that was Left Outside Alone by Anastasia. She had that on the A side and Sick and Tired on the B side of a cassette, and it was always on in my mum's car, and my mum like really used to love Anastasia. I think I actually know this song back to front now, just simply because it was always on when I was about six. Don't diss Anastasia, okay? She had a good voice. The next one really is quite poignant to me, and that is Cat Power's version of Sea of Love. I love this version in particular because when I was starting to first watch YouTube videos and like wondering what it was and like wondering about how I could make my own, I used to watch a lot of Shane Dawson, you know, when he still had his characters and he was doing sketches and stuff. And when he had an emotional video, that would always be one of the songs on the soundtrack. So for me, it kind of signifies old YouTube and my teen years and how much I miss him and how much I miss being a kid and an emo kid and a Hillmo kid and stuff like that. And it is really poignant for that reason. Like, it brings back so many memories for me. Shane Dawson was also one of the things that inspired me to start my own channel as well, so. The amount of YouTubers that I've seen who've said like Shane Dawson was their first YouTube inspiration is ridiculous though. I mean, how much of an impact has he made on YouTube? The next song on the list is just like one of my favourites and I'm so made up I remembered it. It is Misery Business by Paramore. Now, this kicked off my emo phase badly. Like, I'd always listen to stuff like Evanescence and a bit of Fall Out Boy here and there, but Paramore was just... they were royalty to me. Like, I had posters, I had albums, I tried to get Hailey's hair and I couldn't. And I was so annoyed by it because you had to bleach your hair and I wasn't allowed to bleach it. But they were like a gateway band to me because it got me listening to more like female fronted bands. So I got onto This Image, I got onto Hey Monday, I started listening to more Fall Out Boy, I started listening to All Time Low, and you know, just all like the alternative bands like that. I also started worshipping Black Parade, like the whole album, but it brings me on to my next song, Famous Last Words by My Chemical Romance. And there is a reason for this as well. It really just brings back like tons of memories of being 15 or 16. If you were an emo kid in Liverpool in the 2000s, you will know exactly what I'm talking about when I talk about the Hill or Courts. But for those of you who don't know, every single Liverpool emo kid used to meet up on a Saturday, go to a certain place, it depends which area you're from, the Courts or L1 Hill. And we used to just sit off and and like drink and smoke and just chat and socialise for a bit. Like all sorts of music would be playing, but for some reason Famous Last Words sticks in my head. I think it's because as soon as anyone put it on, people would start singing to it. And it just reminds me of good times and having a laugh with my friends, so I just couldn't not include it on my list. Fun fact, I actually went to an emo rave last week with a friend of mine and all of our old like emo tunes were playing and I just couldn't be happier, like the night was so boss. Whew, couldn't get through the list without mentioning Liverpool Once, could we? The next one is Come Together by the Beatles. This song's got a couple of meanings for me, like first off obviously because of my home city Liverpool, but also it signifies my college and it signifies the first time I played on the Echo Arena stage. It was one of the songs on the set list and it was one of the best experiences of my life so far. Like, I know for a fact that it may never happen again. So I'm always going to cherish the memory fondly because it was such a great night. Next up is Danny Boy, like any version of it. And the reason why I've chosen this song is because basically a year after I started college, my nan died and my world was shaken up a little bit. And that's just the one song I can always listen to and remember her quite nicely and quite fondly. I particularly like Eva Cassidy's version. I also really like Girls' Generation's version of it as well. So soft and so gentle. But ever since she went, it's meant a lot to me and it's always made me slightly emotional to listen to. That's why it's on the list. It's staying on the list as well. It's never gonna move. Next up is Beautiful by Anne Ballou. After my nan died, I was in a really, really bad place because everything was mixed up. My whole world was changing. My nan had just died. But as soon as I listened to this song again, everything felt better. Everything, it didn't quite feel right, but I felt slightly happier and a bit more comforted. And I've listened to like all of Amber's album like this. I really do like it. I think it's so happy and so like joyful. This song just really like sticks out to me. I've looked the lyrics up as well and they are just lovely. The next one's one of my favourites and it's Another One Bites the Dust by Queen. I had to include this on my list because it is the first time I had seen my boyfriend before he was my boyfriend. He was actually in a stage production of We Will Rock You. He was Khashoggi and he was amazing. I kind of fell in love with him as he was on stage. And it was like one of his scenes that he was in and it's kind of become one of our songs now. I still love it to this day and every time I listen to it I think of him. The penultimate song is Run To Me by the Bee Gees. This song is mine and my fella's song and it means the absolute universe to me. When we were first going out he used to link the song to me over like Facebook Messenger and every time I'd listen to it I'd just feel so calm and so happy and it's remained our song ever since. And last but not least, Don't Kill My Vibe by Sigrid. I freaking love Sigrid. I love this song in particular because it is the universal song of not caring what people think. And I think that's just what I needed. Like, it's really, really boosted my confidence to listen to this. I also think it's really motivational if you've got goals. For example, it always inspires me to start writing a new song. It inspires me to stop procrastinating. It inspires me to look for a job. All of the above, I just love this song and I'm so happy I've started listening to it. So that is the soundtrack to my life. I really hope you enjoyed it. Please tell me in the comments below one song that you relate to and would always, always be on your list. You can also follow me on Twitter. The details are in the description below. And thank you for watching. Bye.